Hello students, today I am going to discuss binomial distribution as limiting case of hypergeometric distribution. Students, in this, first let me tell you the statement of it. It is hypergeometric distribution tends to binomial distribution under the following conditions. So the first condition is it is n tends to infinity. The second is m by n tends to p. And the third is m minus 1 minus m by n is tends to q. These are the three things we need to remember. So here, you know the formula of hypergeometric distribution. This is the formula, right? Mx and this one. So just put limit n tends to infinity and n tends to infinity on both the sides. So here, after that, we can expand this as m factorial by m minus x factorial into x factorial, n choose x formula. Then n minus m factorial divided by n minus m minus x minus into minus minus n minus into minus plus x factorial here. Then n minus x factorial here. Then again, this if this is in the denominator, no, we can get it to the numerator by flipping it. We can write it as n factorial in the denominator, and above we can write n minus n factorial into n factorial. Then now, students, just understand this thing. If you have something like this, m and m, this m and above m factorial and here m, this same, we will write it as m factorial as m minus 1. It will be going on, right? m minus 1, so on till m minus x plus 1. We will write here. After that, this will get vanished. Only n x factorial will be remaining. Again, understand, students, same for this. We will write here as n minus m minus 1 factorial, n minus m minus 1, so on, till we will write here n minus m plus x plus 1. As we have added 1 here and we removed all this, Again, students, here, n factorial is in denominator, no? So we need to put in denominator all this. We have to write this part as n here in the denominator, n minus 1, so on till n minus n plus 1. So students, this part will be vanished, right? So now we are left with only n factorial here. Then students, just see here, n factorial is in the numerator. We are putting it here, n factorial. Then in the denominator, we have x factorial and n minus x factorial. Now this is in the form of n choose x, right? We can write this one, this whole as n, and we can write it as x, right? N and x we can write. So n choose x. Now we have this values also in this after this, no? So what we will do, we will divide n to all this, the whole part we are going to divide it by n. Now in the numerator we have done, in the denominator also we will divide the whole part by n. So see here, students, down we have written here m by n, all for, then in the denominator also n by n, all this. Now we know that we have had condition, no, n tends to infinity, then it 1 by infinity is 0, 1 by n is 0, then m by n is p. Then so here, students, this is 0, then this is p, then p, then this will become 1 by n is 0, no? So all then it will be multiplied by 1 minus p, 1 minus p, so on, it will be gone till, here it will be going on till x, right? So p, 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 x terms, it is written here. Then here 1 minus p, 1 minus p, so on, it will be going on till n minus x terms, student. So it is n minus x terms here. So we have in the binomial distribution form, n choose x, p power x, n1 minus p, which is q, q power n minus x. This is the answer. Thank you for listening to my lecture. Do like, share and subscribe, students.